Hi guys, this is Artie and this is a new edition of my video blog. This is a video blog about some tech stuff, geek stuff for all of you to enjoy. Let's go! So, have you seen such art house creations like The Matrix, Terminator, or I don't know, maybe 2001 Space Odyssey by Stanley Kubrick? If you have, I have a question for you. Did you have an uncomfortable feeling while you were watching them?
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
At least I did, because the idea of becoming inferior as a species, or maybe even being wiped out entirely, used to give me anxiety when I was a kid. Well, now, as I have grown up a little, I don't have it anymore. But maybe I should. There is a thing that is slowly but steadily moving towards being superior to computer programs we are used to using now. But I have a sneaky suspicion that it won't be limited to them only. I am talking about, of course, artificial neural networks, or ANN as you may call them. So, what are artificial neural networks? Well, to answer that, you might want to define non-artificial neural networks, or biological neural networks, or simply put, neural networks. A biological neural network, or neural circuit, is a population of neurons interconnected by synapses that carries out a specific function. Well, to put it simply, the more interconnections you have, the better your memory and ability to learn things are. Well, an artificial neural network is a system based on the operation of biological neural networks, or, in other words, is an emulation of biological neural system. Artificial neural networks is one of the main tools for machines to learn things, and in some way they replicate the processes that work in the human brain, but are much simpler. ANNs consist of input layers and output layers, as well as hidden layers that transform the input layers into something that the output layers can use. And this is where they are different from the regular computer programs. ANNs aren't created to perform algorithms. They are created to learn, and their applications are pretty amazing, I think. First of all, they can recognize patterns that are way too complex for humans to recognize and to program with. Another thing is deep learning. Explaining the concept may take too much time, so I'll just leave a couple of links for you to do your own research. Well, it's all great, but you might ask, why are there so many people who are excited about them? ANNs might just help you get laid. One ANN was taught to create pickup lines, and there are some real heart melters among them. So, here are some of the examples.
You must be a triangle, cause you are the only thing here. Hey, baby, you are to be a key? Cause can I bear your tooth? You look like a thing, and I love you.
Or maybe you are into some gourmet stuff. Well, in this case, you might like some ANN's creations like completely meat circle or artichoke gelatin dogs. Well, those are all funny, of course, but there are some ways that ANNs have been used that really take my breath away. I got interested in neural networks after alfazero, a ANN created by Google's DeepMind, crushed the most powerful chess engine, Stockfish. Well, now let me give you a little bit of perspective. There are more possible positions in a single game of chess than there are atoms in the universe, in the known universe at least. And chess has been around for a couple thousand years. Millions of books have been written about chess theory, billions of billions of billions of games played. And it took quite some time for modern chess programs to become better at chess than humans. And it took AlphaZero only 4 hours to beat them all. Not only do humans not stand a chance against AlphaZero, even the most powerful software is inferior. And this is where possibilities of neural networks started giving me chills. I kept asking myself, what else can they do? And quite a few things, as it turns out. It is believed that ANNs will be used in medicine for diagnostic systems, biochemical analysis, and drug development. well, and many other things. They might be used to build autopilots, analyze texts, and even create content, music, images, pictures, videos, translation, media, security, entertainment. The list can go on and on. And what is really cool is that they can gamble on the stock market and even predict the price of Bitcoin. And at that point, I started thinking, what's next? And in my imagination, one of the possible follow-ups may be even more intriguing. I believe that in the future, ANNs will be able to solve moral dilemmas. Well, what if we could put all the text about ethics into the input? ANNs will analyze it, and we will have moral dilemmas solved in the output. If they can build algorithms that are too complex by humans, maybe, just maybe, they will be able to make choices that people just can't. Like there is still no definitive answer to the trolley problem. The one where, you know, you have to decide how many people will be turned into pasta sauce by a trolley. What choice would neural network make? Since chess players are now using AlphaZero as a source of the ultimate truth about what moves to make, will it be possible for neural networks to teach us how to solve ethical problems? What if they will be able to solve mathematical problems that mathematicians haven't been able to grasp? What if neural networks will be able to write fugues better than Johann Sebastian Bach did? What if they find the ultimate answer? Up to this moment, people have believed that even though computers are better at calculating and processing information than humans, they aren't able to learn and create. And this may change in the foreseeable future. Of course, I'm not afraid of being conquered by the machines. Well, maybe a little. But if machines will be better at everything that people are believed to be superior now, will there still be any fun in, you know, living and making stuff up?
What is a robot's favorite kind of music?
What?
Heavy metal.
And what do you think about it? Leave your comments in the comment section and we will discuss it. That's gonna do it for this episode. Leave a like if you liked the video, leave a dislike if you didn't like it, and subscribe to my friends and fans. All links are in the description. And see you later, my niggas and bitches!